Am I saying? Not everyone is born a witch. Everyone is born with a good ambition. I want to be a doctor. I want to be a nurse. I want to be a pilot. But along the way, they are introduced to the practices of witchcraft. They dream flying by night. They dream drinking blood, eating meat. They are being initiated to a time that when she is now old, people will say, this one is a witch. They will not just say, this is an old woman, this is Mrs. so and so. They will say, that woman you see right there is a witch, okay? Let me come home. Not everyone is born a thief. Everyone is born with an ambition. I want to be an accountant. I want to be an engineer. But along the way, grade one, he saw a chalk duster. People thought he was playing and misbehaving. Come on, somebody shout yes. Grade six, he stole something else by the desk. And from four, he stole something. He stole the flag for the nation. He stole a uniform for the soccer team. And now that he's no longer in school, he stole a television next door. Now, because of a certain reputation happening, people will no longer call him John. They will say John the thief. People will no longer call him Tatenda. They will say Tatenda the thief. The infirmity, if it stays long enough with you, it gives you a name. If you are sick the first week, we don't mind. But if you are sick for 4 years, if we see you, we say, there she is. She is a sick woman. No one is a prostitute the day that they are born. But because of series of events, she falls today. She says, sorry, Jesus, I won't do it again. Next week, she falls again. She says, sorry, daddy, it was a mistake. The third time, sorry, daddy, I think I have a weakness. And the weakness will become a dominant character. And she becomes a prostitute. When people see her, they don't just see Susan. They see Susan, the prostitute. Which means when an infirmity stays long enough in you, it's risking killing your identity. What am I saying today? If you don't have a run today, we don't mind. But if you don't have money always, we'll say this person is poor and broke. Which means when an identity, when a crisis stays upon you long enough, it gives you an identity. But tonight, in this atmosphere, as we are going to pray, I don't know what has been coming your way. I don't know what has been challenging your identity. I don't know what has been seeking to drown your personality. But Paul says in the word of God that we are more than conquerors. Is somebody hearing me today? Tonight, silver and gold I don't have, but I came in the name of Jesus. I don't care whether your problem has been there for years. There is another solution that is better. Tell your neighbor, there is another solution that is better. Squeeze the hand of your neighbor and say, neighbor, what is it that you have been fighting? There is another solution that is better tonight. Men and brethren, hear me and hear me well. Jesus was manifested for this very reason, that he might destroy the works of the devil. I came to tell someone tonight, that is not over. Don't put a full stop to your place, but put a comma. Don't put an end. If they say that you are on menopause, what can pause can start? What can pause can resume? I came to challenge the report of that doctor. I came to challenge the report of your bank account. I came to challenge the report of descend and say he is still there. But he was buried on a rock. No one can cover the rock, which means it is evidence enough that he's alive. I came to tell you, my brother, Christ is still alive. He is still the same healer. I don't know what is fighting you, whether it is called cancer. Shout in the name of Jesus. Shout in the name. They say you are useful. They say